I am Dr. P. Keshav Kumar, working in Pondicherry University. I am the very close associate of Kalaikuri Prasad for quite a long time. Very particularly in the last stage of his life, and also at the peak stage of his life also, I am very much familiar. In fact, I am the very big fan of Kalaikuri Prasad. We used to. So Kalaikuri Prasad is a rare intellectual of the Telugu society. Why I told the rare intellectual in the sense, he is a leader, writer, creative thinker, the man who has a deep philosophical thinking, that philosophical thinking which is touched with the lives of the people, very particularly the Dalits and other communities. And more than that, he has a knowledge not committed to most of the, this one can find the limitations with other thinkers. They may be very familiar with the idiom and writing and other things, the grammar of the writing. But where Kalaikuri has the international understanding of the very particular international literature, that level, he very big, he has gone through that one, and very particularly the struggles of black writings. And even the people, he likes Pablo Neruda like anything and all. Some of his poems, he himself is translated. I feel it is more than his poems. His translation seems to be very powerful and all, Pablo Neruda's poem and all. And he has written on international affairs many issues, and from the Arafat to Saddam Hussein and like so many people, it is.
In the 90s
onwards, he has written so many pieces on the very wherever alternative movements are there all over the world, which are either resisting the either imperialism or some kind of dominance and ethnic struggles and all.
How many books you have translated to Telugu?
He has, I am not exactly familiar with his total translations and all, since the very problem with him is that nobody put effort on his collecting his books till recent times. Even though such a very major poet, such a major Telugu writer we didn't find even the time, we didn't bother to publish it as a collective, where I believe that Kalaikuri dislikes the careerism, where we can see the many of the writers, even though 2-3 lines are written, they claim as a writer, whether it reached the people or not, won the people or not, that is immaterial. But they are identified and popular with the print world, and they are very happy to be settled with that world, rather than they don't go beyond even that world. But where Kalaikuri is not like that, his lifestyle is different and his writing is different, and he's not bothered to see that kind of careerism we can't see at any single movement and all. The many people are ready to come forward to publish his books and all, he is least bothered. Only last time when he believed that thing, his life seems to be come to the very close days, then he realized, let his publish. He asked me to, you take care of books and you publish at least. He likes very poetry very much and all, at least poetry collections. To establish himself as a poet, since most of the research, you know it very well, the universities, whatever the books are available, based on that they used to go for the research and all. But where last literature is written on many aspects and all, but is not available, mostly alternative magazines and mainstream newspapers and everywhere is written and all, not compiled. It is compiled and nearly more than 300-400 poems might be there. Very selectively, you can say the very good poem. He himself told and all. Then the other day I have seen the nearly 400 songs has written and all. I thought that it is exaggeration. Initially I thought that it is exaggeration, since only very few songs reach it to us and all. Apart from the Karma Bhumilo, Pujanavo, Puva and Bhumiki, Pachani, Ranges, all these contextual songs and all. All these are contextual songs in a Karan Chedu Kata, or it is against the atrocities committed on Jelli, atrocities committed on Tanguturi Indira. On this thing, the Karma Bhumilo Pushina Puva is that poem, that song, it is surfaced. But I found that nearly, he told the other day, Dappu Prakash, he is also a cultural artist. He has sang so many songs, such a powerful songs I never heard. And he has written, people thought that there may be a lot of philosophical debate and ideological debate between there and with the left parties and Dalit parties. With clear cut demarcation, people draw the demarcating lines between these two things as if they are a different kind of worldviews might have, but as a not a different kind of ideological. We can't see when come to the lives or liberation of the people and all, we can't see such a difference. And that's why even at the time of the where he is identified with his writings, the pre-Dalit movement, that means when his early movement with the people who are identified with Veerasam or as a revolutionary poet and all, as a very young age, he walked into the revolutionary life. We were surprised. Just as a young boy, he is 16-17 years, he walked into the movement and embraced that too, not very casually, such a with a powerful voice. That's why people used to, he named himself as Yuvaka. Yuvaka means very young man. But the poetry has written, the songs has written, the kind of potential, the kind of commitment he had is really amazing and all. We can't see such kind of... Of course, already the revolutionary literature defined the canon of literature and all. But one has to see the difference with the within this canon, one has to see the difference. There we can find the Kalyakuri Prasad, the kind of forcefully he has written the poems, what way one has to return, what way it is there on Jyoti, an encounter of the Jyoti in 85s or 80s, he has written, first song he has written, somebody is telling. Many, then after that, that Dappu Prakash, other day, has sang, he is in fact as a party, the Jannati Mandali artist, the man as a troupe along with the Gadar and all, he told me that he's popular so many songs. The very Kalyakuri Prasad. He popularized means he understood that the strength of the, he might have understood the strength of the Kalyakuri Prasad, not particular likes and dislikes. He knows that thing, it may be very reaching very easily to the public and all, Dalit masses and all. That way picked up there, even though there's no song has printed, not available in printing and all, most of the songs, even though only 5-10 songs might be available to us today. But more than that, it is so many songs are there.
People's War has a publication, they have a publication, magazine.
No, it is there. Whatever there in Avatar are regularly in the different names he used to write, Sangamitra, or some other names he told me. And regularly, every 80s or every alternative, every month almost his poem will be there. But when come to songs, maybe very one or two songs may be published in the regular Jannati Mandali compilation will be there and all. But there is no single album, it is on, there is no particular album on Kalyakuri Prasad. Not only the problem with the Kalyakuri Prasad and all, so many writings it is which are in, really in oral culture only. Most of the people's culture, people's songs, this kind of literature, who are politicized the folklore and revolutionary culture, it is really untapped. Now there is no serious attempt to. The same way it is there on Kalyakuri Prasad also, it is so many songs are very popular among the people also, may not be knowing about, maybe otherless. They don't know that who is the other. Maybe initially they may be collective effort while singing and writing, and many people might be involved and all. But I understood that there's so many songs written by the Kalyakuri Prasad, but no song is available except only 5-10 songs where very people are familiar, and that is requires serious research. That doesn't mean that people are not knowing his songs and all. Some other people are actively involved and engaged. Since it is 80s only, late 80s onwards, there is a song. The songs it is compiling to certain extent, there is a great help, and one can see the cultural mood of Telugu society, the uprising of the political struggles of the Telugu society. It will give a lot of hint, not just for the sake of Kalyakuri, but is a reflection of the people's mind and people's struggles. That is, definitely it is a great significance to his writings will be there. if anybody works on this area and to find out the his writings and
Kalyanpuri died in Vijayawada.
No, he is died in Ongolu.
Kanchikcherla
is his native place, and Kanchikcherla is native place. He for some time was here, and all his parents and all passed away, and his brothers and all. He is, nobody is there and all. But even though he for some time was here, he what my feeling is was that for some time he is with his wife in Mangalagiri and all. But I believe that thing personal level, he don't want to be tied down to the any kind of strong emotional personal relations. He always want to be somewhat is free and loose with the people. That's why he understood that Ongolu is a place where a lot of good number of Dalit middle class will be there, the town. And they will take care of him, since he demands the society, he will take care of. The people also reciprocate like that only, and the people means, writers means, who should live in society, he has every right to not only owning the society and all, people also should own the writers and all. Such kind of impression is created. We won't find any writer just like that is very casually living with the people without looking for any other kind of this, other kind of name and fame or other, not bothered, just he lived like a Buddhist Bauddha bhikshu. He may not be identified with the like that, the attire and not be there, but one can see the lifestyle where the one can see the life of the Bauddha bhikshu who lives with the Sangha. He didn't find any. If he really want to be settled somewhere as a little bit compromise or little bit calculation, he'll be in a good position. The kind of talent it has in in film songs, even alternative genre also, he'll be seems to be powerful. Nobody will compete for him and all such a level it is there.
They owned him
and last moment he lived in the Ambedkar Bhavan, and many people used to come and meet him and all. He told me that you take me there rather than this place or other places and all. Take me to the I am very happy to be living in the Ongolu. Ongolu is a Bhajan Katalu magazine, it is there, and also you can read it. You can regularly contributing that he is a gestator.
He stopped writing long back, man.
He stopped writing, but he used to give the sessions. He never, his mind is very sharp. He's one can see the Kalyanpuri Prasad in every corner of the, every milestone of the Dalit movement. He's a decision maker and all. He used to give the, what we can say, direction to the this thing. Almost all these, whatever the Dalit struggles is there, today we may be familiar with so many struggles, so many splinter groups, so many parties, so many leaders. Some may be good, some may be bad, some are very, very limitedly, because there may be a lot of limitations might be there. But he walked along with all them. At the same time, he keeps distancing with the all the struggles by seeing the strength and demerits of the struggles. He foresighted every movement and all. He don't discourage them and all. He used to identify with all the struggles. At the same time, he personally himself is very cautious. One by his personal life, he may be very anarchic and all. But he likes to Raskolnikov and this kind of images. Or hero of our times, the hero Pechorin, this kind of lifestyle, maybe the influence of kind of literature is exposed. This kind of influence, but when come to the political writing, he's very committed. And not only committed, one can see the sincerity and all. He never be compromised. He just he don't give any, whatever he feels that thing in written word, he never be keep down himself or carried with the wind. He never be carried with the wind and all. Very sincere and objective and committed. This kind of things one can be seen politically in his writings. It is there. But if you see the kind of the translations he had, he has for some time. Translation also is a part of life. He went there and all, whatever it is there. He wants some money. Just he used to go for with the Gita, Hyderabad Book Trust, he used to go there. Whatever the books he like it, not their choice he used to do. His choice will be there always and all. Now his choice is poems or some kind of small pieces, small magazines, small pieces he used to.
How was his translation?
But I used to wonder how is a university professors and all, they feel very difficult to translate. Even the single para, they will take lot of time. People won't expect him such a level of familiarity with the language and all. People, whether this fellow translate or people have, one may have doubt after seeing the intellectuals who have the doctorates and all. But the man, I also surprised to see his translations and all. What he used to do, not like word to word translations. He used to understand the essence of that one, but to come to translation, but we can see the exact translation without corrupting the sentence. Very powerful translation. Sometimes people used to say translation is powerful, since he knows whom he is addressing and all. That level is
now all of your compiling is fine.
The some of the essays it is compiled in the name with this thing. It is Pidikad Atmagauram Kosam. Actually, this is the title for his, of his poem and all. It is the one can see the, it is the, one can give the, it is, gives the documentation of the Dalit movement, we can
when
see.
When was it published? When was it published?
No, this is published very recently, it is there, and it is copies still, it is, they have to go for print, very few copies at the time of his 50th year they celebrated.
Recently,
at the time they released the book.
He himself
is presented. People thought that not rather than we should celebrate our writers, not after their death. Let us have people understood that the Kalekuri will be in a last stage. Everybody has a sense of feeling and all that kind of. This himself is tasting the death every day and all. He don't bother to. But that feeling it is everybody has smelled.
So that in, now you are going to compile this book?
This is some of writings.
Poems.
It is still injustice has done to him. No single collection it is there and all. Yes, some books are there, it is there and all. This is a poem, Antarani Prema. Okay. Antarani Prema it is there and all, untouchable love. In personal relations also, how, what kind of problem will be there? Not only just politics talking about, how caste plays in a role in the, this thing. This is a book. Here some poems, there is an effort by Vidyasagar and friends to get some of his poems and all. But by seeing this thing, but so many poems are there and all. But not only poems, some other essays also they put together and all. Where Dalithi Karanalu earlier has written on some of the iconic and legendary figures in Dalit.
So you are planning to collect all of the poems?
No, poems has to be, somebody has to take this thing. I don't know how far we will be, succeed in this endeavor. But poems, it is, he likes any writer, even though so many powerful essays are there in this thing. But more than this, he likes poetry. They want to see the creative life. The people, they want to be celebrated more as a poets, even the other kinds of designation and all. In the Kalekuri also, very much fond of the such kind of this thing as to be in a poet, in a remembered in a Telugu society, to be a poet, since he knows his commitment and his strength and the kind of language, uncompromising struggle will be loaded in his words and all. He's a very powerful writer. Dalit writers, I believe that thing. I don't think anybody will come to such a close kind of, close to such a Kalekuri in the kind of idiom, the kind of wording and the kind of philosophical depth. Other people has written, I am not to belittling the other writers and all. Yes, Dalit literature has a different genres and different people are there. And they're good in that they bring out the very ordinary language into the literary world and they are very succeed. Madhuri, Nagesh Babu and other Teresh Babu and Satish Chandra and so many writers, young writers came, whoever they can be just have written something about the everyday life. Whatever that's written, the known life they written, they become a poetry and all. Such a kind of...
You mean to say that Kalaikuri, after writing so much, he never was recognized as a poet?
People recognize his poet. There's no doubt
mainstream,
about
the mainstream.
No, mainstream also he knows
recognized.
His impact.
Mainstream recognized him as a poet.
No, mainstream. No, mainstream also more than anybody. He is Kalaikuri name is known in all the circles, whether it is left circles or the feminist circles or it is any other alternative identity politics. His kind of friendship, personal friendship and rapport with this. My point is that compared to other Dalit writers and all, there we can feel they may be play with the words and they may be the social life, the rich social life, some way they put up in the words, the strength might be there. But where Kalaikuri Prasad, he has a philosophical depth it is there and all. Because of that, his poetry is very strong and very powerful.